This tutorial covers standard setup on 400 in Stepan. The instrument operates at ambient temperature and all the way up to 146 degrees C, which is the last calibrated point. In the idle state, we have a magnet and a probe and a supply of room temperature nitrogen gas. VTU is off and supplies instrument with 100 liters per hour of gas, which first direct you to the BCU, Brooker cooling unit, which is currently off in a flush or zero position, essentially just supplying room temperature gas to the probe. The probe passes gas towards the heater is off, and it supplies room temperature air to the sample. This is how we work at room temperature. This is the standard state of the NMR instrument for all routine NMR measurements. Every time you finished your variable temperature measurements, you will have to bring the instrument to this state for the next user. Before you begin, you need to verify the current setting of the BCU1. BCU1 is located behind the magnet. Its setting is easier to view if you walk around the magnet to see its front panel. This is a manual unit. The mode switch has four positions. We are checking to ensure that selector is set to flush position or zero. When VTU is turned on, it begins supplying 400 liters per hour of gas to the BCU, which supplies it further to the probe, and the probe heater heats it up to the temperature necessary for the NMR experiment. The lowest regulated temperature for the experiment is about 5 degrees greater than temperature of the gas supply. With the room temperature gas supplied at 20 to 22 degrees C, we should set VTU to 25-27 degrees C or greater for effective regulation. If sample temperature is going to exceed 80 degrees C, we need to open shim gas valve 9 turns from fully closed state. This will supply a stream of nitrogen gas down the shim stack to cool the shim coils. It is important to supply a correct amount of VT gas to the probe. VT gas flow rate depends on the temperature of your experiment. In the range below 80 degrees C, you will be using a blue POM spinner, a regular spinner you use for all routine NMR experiments. In this range, setting for the VT gas flow rate is 400 liters per hour. When going above 80 degrees C, you have to use a ceramic spinner. The ceramic spinner is good for both temperature regions, below 80 and above 80 degrees C. So if your experimental plan is to test temperatures below 80 degrees and then above 80 degrees, you may put your sample into a ceramic spinner right away. All this time, when I was saying temperature, I meant actual, real temperature of the sample. However, VTU of the instrument does not know the real temperature. It operates in relative units, which are close to real temperature in the ambient temperature region, but deviate significantly at high and low temperatures. At the time of recording of this tutorial, the current calibration is of July 2020. They are strictly specific to the probe. If the probe is changed or goes to repair, it has to be recalibrated. Please make sure that you are using actual, most recent calibrations for the specific probe. When we are changing temperature, we create thermal stress in the glass part of the probe head. If temperature is changed too rapidly, this part may crack, and then the probe has to go to Brooker for repair. It is important that when we are ramping spectrometer to specific temperature or cooling it down, we have to take a limited temperature step of 10 degrees and wait at least 3 minutes before the next temperature change is done. It is very important that we return spectrometer back to idle state, to room temperature, in the same stepwise pattern at a slow pace. after you brought spectrometer to 25 degrees C, your next step is to close the shim gas valve and then to turn off the VTU.